The other major story we've been following all weekend, former President Trump is now in Milwaukee for the Republican National Convention just one day after a shooter attempted to take his life. 2 hours ago, President Biden called for an end to political violence.
We cannot, we must not go down this road in America. We've traveled before throughout our history. Violence has never been the answer.
That's President Biden earlier tonight from the Oval Office, 24 hours after the attempted assassination of former President Trump.
Take a look at what happened.
The FBI identified the shooter as 20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crooks, a registered Republican from Pennsylvania. He was killed by the Secret Service. Tonight, President Biden updated the nation on the investigation into the shooter.
We do not know the motive of the shooter yet. We don't know his opinions or affiliations. We don't know whether he had help or support or if he communicated with anyone else.
Former President Trump taking to Truth Social Sunday, thanking supporters and writing, "It was God alone who prevented the unthinkable from happening. We will fear not, but instead remain resilient in our faith and defiant in the face of wickedness." On social media, Trump also said that he will still be going to the Republican National Convention in Milwaukee, saying he will not let a gunman change his schedule. Former First Lady Melania Trump today has made her first comments about the attempted assassination of her husband. She says, "When I watched that violent bullet strike my husband, Donald, I realized my life and Barron's life were on the brink of devastating change. I'm grateful to the brave Secret Service agents and law enforcement officials who risked their own lives to protect my husband." And now to the story of a man who was in the stands and witnessed the moment Trump was shot. He told his story to News 8's Kyla Russell.
I heard pop, 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 pop.
Lost in a sea of MAGA hats, observer Josh Dressbling sat in a front row less than 50 yards from the former president. He came to the Butler, Pennsylvania rally to witness the spectacle. He never knew he'd witness a different kind of history.
I heard the sound off to my right, and within, you know, what seemed like hours in my head was only a few seconds, realized that this was not somebody with firecrackers screwing around.
It was something far less celebratory.
It was sounds, and and I saw him do this, you know, and I turned and looked to my right because that's where, to me, it was coming from.
Shots and then silence. Behind the lens, Josh captured the moment.
Saw him go down and Secret Service and encompass the podium there and everything, and honestly thought he was done. You know, I mean, he was down, he went down, and everybody's like, they shot Trump.
Simultaneously, attendees used what they had to find safety.
When shots fired and everything, everybody dropped to like their knees or on all fours, and boyfriend, girlfriend, husbands, wives, parents and children are, you know, huddling each other down on the ground, you know, when shots are fired kind of thing, you know, like you'd see in a movie.
Josh specified it would be a horror movie, with only one word to describe it.
Silence, eerie silence. Like, just everybody was there, just jaw dropped. Like, is this real? Is this surreal? Is like, is this a joke?
Then quiet turned chaos.
Heard the commotion to my right, where that video that I sent you is filmed from. One guy walked down in his own power, and they took him around into the grass off the way there, and he was laying on the ground. They were working on him. I don't know the extent of his injuries or anything, but then they eventually did load him into an ambulance.
And then came the aftermath, moments etched in memory.
People crying and tearful, and, you know, and after, you know, after Trump had left, I mean, there was people with their head in their hands just crying, and there was a whole just gamut of emotion from the crowd.
As reality set in, so did the day's page in history.
When I was standing there taking pictures, one of the things that ran through my head now that I think back at it was, oh, Lincoln and Reagan, and, you know, and I'm like, this is like history in the making.
That's Kyla Russell reporting. And now, all eyes turn to the security at the Republican National Convention in Milwaukee. The Secret Service says it is not planning to change its security plan. The agency also says there are no known threats against the RNC or anyone visiting the convention. The Wisconsin Republican Party chairman says he is not worried about security.
This
This is probably one of the most secure areas on the planet right now. We have thousands of law enforcement agencies from all over the state and all over the Midwest here, and I think they're doing a great job. I really do.
The convention starts tomorrow and will run through Thursday. We want to make sure you're informed with the latest information in the attempted assassination of former President Trump. And we've made it easy for you. Just grab your phone and scan the QR code on your screen right now. That will take you to the As Seen On section of WishTV.com.